Now, I'm a generations expert. I'm currently writing a history of generations from baby boomers right through, not just Generation Z, but the generation after them, Generation Alpha, those born after 2010. And I work with a lot of companies seeking to really ascertain and analyze and help them deal with the generational gap in their business. This cohort is the best educated generation in history. 50% of global millennials have a first degree. 32% have a second degree, okay? So these guys are learners by default. It's really important, it characterizes how they see the workplace in particular. This is the generation who cannot remember a time before the financial crisis. And this is the generation who cannot remember 9/11, okay? So, in terms of their context and their understanding of the world, it's really important you've kind of conceptualized where they're coming from and what their reality looks like. These guys were the kids whose parents said, no, we can't afford it. These guys came of age and were, you know, growing up at the deepest recession, at a time of the deepest recession in history. So that colours their attitudes towards money, savings, stability, and the future. If we've got these four generations in the workplace, how do we kind of think about the ways in which the workplace is changing? Okay, because it is fundamentally changing. These guys are obsessed with their mental health, and actually what is remarkable at university level is the provisions and the support given to students to help them with their stress, anxiety, and depression. And when they go into the world of work, they're going to expect similar support levels and similar level of openness, okay? And it's really important that companies get on side with that mental health agenda. Problem with most companies is they're still catering for the three-stage life. And actually what you need to be catering for is what I call the multi-stage life. What these kids want is a multi-stage career, okay? They want to be learning, they perhaps want periods of self-employment, they perhaps want periods of extended leave, they perhaps want periods where they are setting up their own business. They want a multi-stage career. So what can your company do to satisfy their desire for multiple experiences? Agile working is not just about having a blanket company policy that says everyone can work at home on a Friday. It's actually offering bespoke, flexible working arrangements. Creating a family-friendly environment that enables people to have that fluidity between home life and work life. And also the impact on them as employees. All of them said it had made them more productive. All of them said it had made them more loyal to the company. And all of them had said it had strengthened the family relationship and obviously the bond with the child. It's not just about parenting, because one of the things that millennials are going to have, even more than Generation X who do right now, is care for the elderly, okay? As someone who basically had to nurse their father last year, I know the pressures that it puts on your job and your work responsibilities. There is no stronger definition of investment in an individual than helping them learn, helping them progress, helping them develop. And of course, we have a great demonstration of that in Ivy House development project itself. But it's so important to remember that millennials have been learners longer than any other generation. Learning is ingrained in them like no other generation before them. Creating a democratic environment and enabling millennials to speak and break down some of those hierarchies and silos is again the easiest way, and indeed the cheapest way, you can increase their sense of validation and loyalty and place in the business. The values of the company have to align with the values of the individual. and you have to help them on that journey. Because if you don't, and there's a niggle internally inside of them saying, I'm just not comfortable with this, or I'm not comfortable here, or this company doesn't reflect my values, then they will go. They will go despite the £250,000 bonus. They will go despite the learning and development, despite the great parental leave program you have. Because as we know, there's no worse waste of resources than investing in people that then leave. It's the worst thing that a company does and the easiest way to lose money. And indeed, I think if you think about their ever-changing demands and go some way to meeting them, they will go a long way to retaining a loyalty to your firm. Thank you very much.